Hello students, welcome back to your video class. In the previous videos we have discussed about the tense. In we have done the exercises and we have done the practice of present, past and future time, and we have used present and the past finite verbs in the three timings. So hello students, welcome back to video class. And as we have discussed about the tense and subject and verb agreement, in subject and verb agreement we have done the subject and verb agreement of present tense, and subject and verb agreement of past tense, and subject and verb agreement of the future time. Note the tense, as we have made it very clear that there is no such a tense called future. Well, today we are continuing this topic. We have done exercise of present, past and future. We have done the exercise of subcategories of present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous, and like that the other tense like past indefinite, past continuous, past perfect and past perfect continuous, and then future indefinite time, then the future continuous time, future perfect and perfect continuous. Well, now if you remember, we have from the beginning we have talked about finite and non-finite verbs, and then we talked about the 9, 5 and 10 verbs. If you remember, the 9 verbs represent present, the 5 verbs represent past, and the 10 verbs represent future time, or you can say the modal verbs. And I told you why these verbs are called modal verbs: shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, dare, need, used to, and these are the modal verbs. And why these are called the modal verbs, I told you, because these verbs show the mood of the person. These things we have done. Now, if we talk about subject verb agreement, as I tell you, we have done it in the earlier class, like subject and verb are the most important part of a sentence. Subject plus verb. Well, these are the most important part in a sentence. Well, to form a complete sentence we need subject and verb. However, there are 8 parts of speech, 8 words of speech, but we need to complete a sentence. In a complete sentence you will find 2 things: subject and verb. Subject, you can say it can be with the, like, you know, sometimes it is noun, sometimes it is verb, pronoun, sometimes can be preposition, sometimes adjectives. So, verb, and with verb, as I told, this verb is always finite verb, either present or past. So, this is very important thing. Now, let me tell you further about subject and verb agreement. As I told you about the subjects, like, our subject is, if subject is singular, subject is singular. Subject singular means when the subject is singular, we use the verb form in plural. When subject is plural, we use the verb form singular. How? See, subject singular, he. Suppose he, or any other, you can take any other form. He plays. We play. See, he plays, we play. And this difference goes, actually here plays actually is not used like a form of verb, and in the sense it does not make many verbs like it makes the nouns, like when we change the noun, any noun like bags. So bags means it makes more than one, but here it is not like that when you see a verb with s, it means there are many verbs. No, this is a form. This is one form, already one form when we change singular to plural. But here it does not mean that it has many more verbs, but this is the plural form in the sense. But on the other hand, this is without s. So play is a form which is used with plural numbers. Plays is a form which is used with singular numbers. So like this, you can take some other examples here. We can write makes, okay, comes, teaches, again here simple, make, come, teach. So this way go, and here we can write she or any name, Ram, it, she, or this, we, they, you, okay, Raz and Rani. Okay, so these are plural numbers. These are plural numbers. These are singular numbers. So with singular numbers we use this form, and with the plural we use these forms. But one is there, I. Well, we cannot define I according to the number. We cannot define I according to the use of verb. I means sometimes, if we see I means I only one person. I only one person. But we use the pattern, we use the structure which is sometimes used in the plural and sometimes used in the singulars. How? See, I plus I was, this is used with the singulars. But sometimes we use I have, this is used with the plurals, and I am, this is used only with I, nothing else. So with I we have subject and verb agreement somewhat differently. And otherwise, overall, we can make a simple generalization, like with singulars and plurals, we can simply use them, we can define them somewhere. And I is different form of subject, or you can say it has its verb agreement differently. Somewhere it will be using the verbs of singulars, somewhere it will be using the form of plurals. So somewhere only like am, there is am which is never else used without I. So these are the subject and verb agreements according to the forms, according to singular and plural forms. Now we have done the exercise of the tenses, and we have done the exercise of the verb forms, and in that I told you the finite and non-finite verbs, all that. So you can note down in your notebook these content, you must note down so you can better understand later. And now I erase it so I can go further with this topic. So I'm talking about the structures. Tense is what? Tense, actually it is structure. Now totally I'm writing here the structures, present. Okay, present, I'm starting again with the present, and I'm writing the structures, and I will be explaining them one by one. So I start with present, and in present I start with present indefinite, present indefinite. Well, as we talk about subject and verb agreement, and I have told you the rules how we add subject and verb. So let's see structure. In this we have a structure. What is the structure? What is the structure in present indefinite? Well, write down subject plus subject plus present form of verb. Present form of verb plus object. So structure, subject, present form of verb, object. Well, now subject. As I wrote many subjects, singular or plural subjects, according to that we write the subject and present form of verb and object. Object is a new thing for you here. Object means rest of the part. After the verb, the rest of the part of a sentence is called object. So, with one or two example, you can better understand what are the forms, what are the present forms. First, we need to know forms are like is, am, are, has, have, okay, do, does. I told you, if you remember, how many forms? 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 2 verbs. Simply any main verb you can take. For example, I took here make, makes, or play, plays, or come, comes, or teach, teachers, help, helps. Any one you can say, play, plays. Say, play, plays. These are the verbs. These are the present form of verbs which are used in present indefinite. Present indefinite. These verbs are used. Now, I have already told you in these verbs which verb you will use with singular subject and which verb you will use in plural subject, with plural subject. So, like is, I told is a singular with singular. Now, singular subject plus the verbs which we can use is, has, does, plays. Okay, plays. Now, plural subject plus we use with plural are, have, do, and play. Means four. Okay, and as I told you, M is only for I. M is only for I. It means I am. Subject, verbs, agreement for present indefinite. This is the structure. If anyone asks you, tell the structure of present indefinite. So, without any hesitation, without any doubt, you can say it is subject plus present form of verb and object. Means this is the structure. So now you have understood the structure and you have understood the singular and plural subject and their agreement with the subject. So now next thing is, these all are the verbs which show present indefinite. If you see this combination, only this combination plus, then after that no verb, only object, only these verbs, okay, only these verbs, okay, and after that only object. So it means you can say that the sentence is of present indefinite. This is the identification of structure. This is the identification of present indefinite. You can identify, you can understand present indefinite with the help of the structure, with the help of the subject and verb agreement, and with the help of the finite and subject verb, and use of finite verb according to the present. So, students, you note down this structure and these agreements also in your notebook. So, I go to the next point. So next is we call how we use these the verbs and how we make the sentences of present indefinite. I tell you with the one example in a sentence, like one, he is a good boy. Okay, he is a good boy. Now you can see he is a good boy. Subject, verb, object. Subject, verb, object. Next, second sentence is she has a she has a car. Now subject, verb, object. Okay, third, you can see he does his work well. Now he, subject, does, verb, his work well, object. Next is any simple verb, any main verb in the form of plural, like he runs very fast. Okay, he runs very fast. Subject, verb, object. So he runs very fast. On the track, it can be long, doesn't matter how long your object can be, but these are the subject and verb agreement. And now on the other side with the plural numbers, how we use, I tell you with plural forms, like we are friends. We are friends. We are friends. Subject, verb, object. Next, 5-6 sentences. They have a new house. Subject, verb, object. Okay, next is 7 number. Okay, you do your own work. You, subject, do, verb, your own work, object. Now 8th number, sentence number 8, with this form, like they play football every day. They play football every day. They, subject, play, verb, football everyday object. And the last sentence with am, as I told you, with am. So with am we use here sentence that is 8th, 9th sentence. I am free today. I am free today. Subject, verb, object. And I tell you, with I am free today, we have some separate combinations. Now, 9, number 10, I write here, I have a fever. I have a fever. Subject, verb, object. Okay, 11 number, I do my work. Subject, verb, object. Last is 12 number. I write here 12 number. I run not with I write any other form. I learn French. So subject, verb, object. These are the 12 sentences which explain the structure of present indefinite and all the verbs which we use in present indefinite, and subject and verb agreement with the singular, plural, and the subject, and if the subject is singular, which verb we use. If the subject is plural, then which verb we use. And with I subject, I have told you all the four type of 9, 10, 11, 12, these four sentences very separately, so you may not confuse with the use of I. So these are the sentences, 12 sentences, which explains very well the use of the 9 verbs, only 9 verbs which are used in present indefinite. And you will note down these 12 sentences, and you will mention subject, verb, object in every sentence, as well as your own. You will write each with each type. Means 12 means 12, these 12 sentences, and more you will write your, this is your HW, you will write each type 3 more sentence. Each type 3 means with is you will write 3 more sentences with is, like he is, she is, okay, Ram is, my friend is, any with subject, with any subject you will write with each verb. With is 3, with has 3 more, with does 3 more, with here you can change the verb and you can write 3 more sentence. Then number 5, we are, with are 3 more, with have 3 more, do, with do 3 more, and they play, here play, you can write 3 new verbs, and with they you can make new sentences. With I am you can make 3 more sentence, but you will not changing am. I am, you can change the object. I am okay, I am honest, I am a student, I am busy, I am at home. You can change the object, but you will not be changing am. Then 11, I do, with I do, this type 3 more. And 12, I learn, with I you will change this verb and you will write 3 more sentences. So there will be 3 more, each type means 36 sentences. 36 36 sentences. Means with each type 3. So total are 12 type. So you will write 3 with multiply by these 12, 36, and somewhere you can use the new verbs, or you can change the object. Like, he is a good boy, so you can write here, he is my friend, he is at home, he is busy, he is very handsome, he is very intelligent. So this way you will make 3 more. She has a car, she has a bike, she has beautiful hair, she has some work, he does his work, he does very well, she does very well, my friend does very well, my mother does very well. So this way you will write, he runs, he makes, he takes, he eats, he plays, he cooks, he cleans, he washes. You can make like this the new sentences. So when you do this exercise, you send the work to me. As soon as you complete it, I will check it. I will check your sentences and will tell you if you make any mistake. And we'll continue with this topic, still present indefinite. And our next video will be on how we identify the verb in a sentence, or how we identify a tense. So there are a few things, and where we use these structures, where we use is, where we use are, and where we use these simple forms. So there are a few situations there we use present indefinite in writing as well as in speaking. I hope you have understood this very well, and you must note down whatever I have taught here, whatever I have written, you must note down in your notebook, so it may help you later. And the SW I have told you, you must do it, and you must send it to me as early as possible. Thank you. Have a nice time.